Well, good morning to you. Today is Tuesday, it is August the 31st, and I am your host, the Troublemaker Extraordinaire, coming to you recorded from the comforts of my Lazy Boy recliner here at Wake Up Central with the Tuesday edition of the Morning Wake Up Call. Excuse me one moment. Feeling a little bit not so hot at the moment. I've got my canteen here with water in it. Let's see. Before we get rocking and rolling here, I've got to make this one announcement. My good friend Lonnie had her birthday yesterday. Although I did send her messages on Facebook wishing her happy birthday, I got severely fussed at for not verbally saying happy birthday here on the show. So, happy birthday, Lonnie. Now here's the next deal, you know. Now everybody that's had a birthday or is going to have a birthday is going to be reminding me now, saying, "You got to put my birthday on the show." Anyway, Lonnie, I believe, turned, 29 again for, I think, the 29th time. Ricky Ray, you know, the president of the Redneck Crew, took her out to dinner last night. Good job. Anywho, taking a look at the weather forecast for the Jackson-Madison County metro area. Oh, by the way, happy birthday, Lonnie. Today we're looking at partly cloudy skies with a high in the lower 90s. Tonight, clear with the low in the upper 60s. Looks like it's going to be a pretty fair day. There is a 20% chance of precipitation. So hopefully we'll be in the 80% most of the day. Oh, by the way, happy birthday, Lonnie. News headlines. Federal investigators probe a fire at a mosque site. This comes out of Nashville, Tennessee. On Sunday, a construction site for an Islamic mosque was vandalized. Reports indicate that several of the construction equipment was doused with gasoline, and one of them was set on fire. The ATF, the FBI, the TBI, and the RCSO, and probably a few other initials, are investigating the situation as we speak. They pretty much do not know anything except for several construction equipment was doused with gasoline and one of them was set on fire. I wonder how long it took them to figure that out. Paris Hilton busted on drug charges Friday in, where was this? Las Vegas, yes. Friday in Las Vegas, Miss Paris Hilton was arrested after police saw smoke coming out of the windows of a black Escalade to which they suspected to be marijuana. They was not sure, they just suspected. Once searching the vehicle, they found cocaine in Miss Hilton's possession. She was booked and then later released in the early hours of Saturday morning. Her attorney released this statement. Paris Hilton was released this morning on her own recognizance. This matter will be dealt with in the courts and not in the media. I encourage people not to rush to judgment until all the facts have been dealt with in the court of law. There will be no interviews and no more comments at this time. That comes from David Kreshnoff, Ms. Hilton's attorney. He is encouraging that no judgments be rushed to. However, apparently the police department rushed to judgment when they see smoke. They just automatically assumed it was marijuana rather than just regular smoke. So Ms. Hilton and apparently a few others were arrested. Ms. Hilton was the only person that was actually let out of jail. The rest of them are still in jail. If convicted, Ms. Hilton could face 1 to 4 years in prison. I very seriously doubt that one. Lohan on the run In the wee hours of Saturday morning, Lindsay Lohan was pulled over for running a red light in Los Angeles, driving her brand new $150,000 Maserati. She was on her way to her favorite party spot. Apparently, she was using a few of the 433 horses that are under the hood to get away from the paparazzi. Who knows? Maybe she and Paris can be cellmates one day. Dolphin snot for DNA. According to scientists, the discharge from the blowhole on tops of dolphins and whales contains DNA samples which could be easier and less painfully extracted from the animals. This is an alternative to other methods used, such as crossbows with retractable darts or spears for collecting tissue samples. Why do you need DNA from a dolphin anyway? Leave Flipper alone, let him swim out in the ocean, and let's just be happy, okay? Sports news, $1 million head of hair. The hair care company Head and Shoulders has taken out a $1 million insurance policy. Let me say this again. Listen, the hair care company Head and Shoulders has taken out a $1 million insurance policy on Pittsburgh Steelers safety Troy Polamalu's hair. Yes, the $1 million insurance policy is on a head of hair to ensure that his trademark locks will not get damaged during the current NFL season. I'm thinking if Head and Shoulders has $1 million that they don't know what to do with, send it my way. I can help them out. You ought to see dude's hair. I mean, there was a picture of Fox News of dude's hair, okay? His hair was whiter than the picture. According to the report, he has not cut his hair in 7 years. Dude don't need a helmet, okay? Quote of the day comes from Robert Zend. There are too many people and too few human beings. I kind of get to you on that one, Mr. Zend. Good quote. Thank you. Useless information. The word politics, if broken down, you can find the actual definition. So we take politics. The word poly is a Latin word meaning many. M-A-N-Y, not M-I-N-I. Poly, many. Then, as we all know, ticks are those little blood-sucking creatures. So politics is a group of many blood-sucking creatures. Go figure. Well, boys and girls, that is today's show. I hope you have enjoyed it. I shall be back here tomorrow for the Wednesday edition, the hump day edition of Wake Up Call. Unless this head congestion and whatnot goes, south and I end up, really with no voice. Anyhow, I hope you all have a wonderful day, a wonderful rest of the week. Like I said, I'll be back tomorrow. Before we go, I've got to say happy birthday to my good friend Lonnie. Yesterday was her birthday. She turned 29 again. And I also have to do the legal mumbo jumbo. The views and opinions expressed on the show are those of the host, guest, and fans, and not necessarily those of any organization represented by these individuals. Wake Up Call is a production of Free Speech Communications and may be replayed at any time for your viewing pleasure. The contents of this show are meant to only be entertaining and possibly sarcastic. Should you have any issues regarding the show, you are encouraged to forward any and all comments to my Facebook account. Guys, if you're trying to make me look like the Palamahu guy, that afro is way too small. Too small. Palamahu's hair was bigger than the screen. Anyway, that's it for today. I shall see you later. Hope you have a wonderful day. And God bless you.